As y'all are icons and the leading marketers in Sri Lanka, I would like to know how would you define marketing and why do you think marketing is important?
The basic principles of any business is the same. You know, it's about having a proposition, which is a product or a service that meets a consumer need. And you figure out a way of producing that proposition at a cost that gives you the best return while delivering or satisfying the need of that consumer.
Everything in this world revolves around marketing. The basic definition of marketing, it's all about identifying, anticipating and satisfying needs of the consumer. And you know, that process also involves proper communication, building long-term relationship and making sure that it's a win-win relationship, right?
If we want to create an organization to make a differentiation, to have a competitive edge, and to survive and to succeed, we need to convert the entire organization into a marketing-driven organization. So that is why I asked you the question, do you still think marketing as a function or a department should exist in your organization, or should you convert the entire organization into thinking marketing? Marketing shouldn't be a function only, a department only, a silo. It should be an organization-wide philosophy, a way of working where putting the customer in the center of your business.
What are the qualifications that are available, whereas marketing education plays a major role in the marketing industry? What are the qualifications?
What the corporates need is professional marketers. Now, this is where the qualification bit comes in. How do you make yourself professional in whatever you do? So therefore, I think it's important to understand the options, the alternatives that you have to make yourself not just marketers, but professional marketers. Qualification doesn't make you a practitioner. So therefore, you need to understand when you're looking out for qualifications, how well the qualification teaches you the fundamentals of the subject matter that you're going to learn. In the same time, how well it equips you with the competencies that you need to become a professional marketer. Look for qualification that equips you obviously with the fundamental understanding of the subject, but also together with the competencies that you need to become great marketers in the fraternity.
How can one really develop themselves to become or develop their career in 2021 or in this era going forward to become corporate professionals, and how can they really demonstrate them as professional marketers or professionals in the industry?
Couple of ways to do that. One is actually to stay up to date with the changes, the advancements in the profession. Stay up to date with the trends. Stay up to date with the changes in thinking. How has big data come into play? How has digital marketing come into play? How is the social media space moving? To understand the big picture. Because marketing is no more about just being the advertisers of the company. You know, it's not about developing a 30-second TVC or a TV ad. It's about being strategic. What is the larger picture of the business? What are the strategic objectives the business wants to drive? Understanding the external environment, how is that changing? It's actually being flexible to change. Because changes are happening, what you did yesterday in a particular way, you cannot do today. So as marketers, we have to realize that it's important to understand, not just understand what's going on, but also be flexible enough to change whatever we are doing. It could be a strategy, it could be even the product proposition. How do we change what we are doing? And it's not change for change's sake, it should be change that's really relevant and resonates through some understanding of what the consumer is looking for, or a change that has happened, in the consumer's behavior or in the external environment.
Tell us about the digital marketing aspect of marketing industry and how is it important?
It helps you to be more efficient marketers, because in advertising it says, I don't know whether you guys still talk about it, in all these places, but 50% of your advertising is a waste and you don't know which 50%. But it's not a valid statement anymore when you apply that to digital marketing, because you can track and measure everything you do digitally. Let's say you do something wrong, you know what you did wrong and you can learn from it. And you want to test 5 ads at the same time, you can easily do it. And you want to create audiences and you want to say, okay, my customer is with characteristics ABC, show me more of them. Digitally, you can easily do it. With audience targeting and stuff like that. There's so many tools available for marketers to be more efficient using digital marketing. So you can do things faster, do things better, do things more efficiently, and you can reduce the waste and you can efficiently use your budgets and reach the customers and understand their thinking. For example, if you do a digital campaign, you know how long they spend on your platform, you know, which page of your platform that they exit. You know, you see a lot of people exiting from this step. Is it wrong with my pricing, or my pictures are not great, or my content is not enough, or anything wrong with my payment gateway, or engagement is low? All of that can be tracked. So in the modern world, digital marketing is very important for a couple of reasons. One, you're talking to a huge audience. Two, you can be more efficient. And three, you can understand your customer better.
Specifics and the details of education. In order to pursue a career, to become a professional marketer, what are the elements you think a qualification in marketing should include?
We need to bridge the upcoming graduates, marketers, to the corporate requirement. So that's a starting point that I would like to talk about. Where we see the way we could do this is through matching the competencies that needs to be developed to the competencies that is required in order to carry out the task in hand at corporate levels. What a professional qualification? Now, I mean, I want to really touch on the stream PG deep, because this, without a doubt, I could call it a very comprehensive, a very updated program. Why am I saying so? Is because we've looked at we've really scanned what the market needs and what the requirements the top marketers and corporates have, and we have designed a program at SLIM in order to give that back to the society, so that there is a bridge, there is a connection between the competencies that needs to be developed versus the competencies that is required. The marketing we learned yesterday is obsolete today. So we have to prepare our graduates to become ready for tomorrow. So therefore, we very carefully selected elements in terms of content about things like adding corporate IoT, Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, machine learning, data-driven marketing. There's a heap of related and relevant, an updated version of the program that is up there for graduates to look at. Right. So these are in terms of content. Then I spoke about the big picture, we've also bringing in elements such as sustainable marketing. We're also looking at things like purpose-driven marketing. There is a purpose. Gone are the days that people just bought your product. Gone are the days that people bought only the lowest price product or the most communicated product. Today, they want to understand what's the cause behind your product or service. So therefore, we bring in the relevance. We work with industry experts to bring in all the relevance, all the versions of the current context, and plug it into a postgraduate diploma in marketing program. And this is why we now name this program as postgraduate diploma in marketing management. It's not about giving fundamentals of marketing, but actually equipping those upcoming marketers to become marketing managers and add value to the corporate sector.
How important it is to be educated, or how important it is to be qualified in marketing, and what are the opportunities you see in this 21st century for the qualified marketers?
One of the basic principles we learn as marketers is we learn differentiation. How do you differentiate your product? So here the question is, how do you differentiate yourself? So a qualification can do that. Important things is, you know, having that qualification that you can demonstrate that you understand, you're a practitioner, that you're able to, you're keeping up to date with the advancements there, you're keeping up to date with the new thinking in the particular field, and that you're able to implement them, put those into practice. So that is absolutely, absolutely vital. The other thing is, now marketers are reaching the boardroom. So marketers now sit in the boardroom. So it's not just important to have a general qualification that has marketing as one module. That's not good enough anymore. You need to have an in-depth understanding of the functional area of marketing, need to understand the principles, need to understand how marketing connects to other functions in the business. How does it drive value for consumer? How does it drive value for shareholder? Opportunities for marketers. I think marketers are going to lead the change, they are going to actually lead the organization's agenda, especially as we come out of a pandemic. So I think for a qualified marketer who's rounded off in all the areas where they understand the big picture, are able to put into practice what they've learned and understand the new thinking coming in, I think, you know, sky's the limit, basically. The postgraduate diploma, I think the practitioners who have actually, who have that qualification, I think that in itself speaks for the qualification itself. You have practitioners who have the PG diploma, who've actually gone up to board level now, and are active practicing marketers. Obviously, the Sri Lanka Institute of Marketing is the apex body of marketing in the country. So I don't think there is a greater recognition for a qualification rather than that, because it's very clear. So that the program, as Aruz mentioned, actually covers the entire gamut of what we've been speaking about today, and that recognition is there in the market. So employers, they understand that. Organizations, they understand that. So marketers who do have that qualification behind their name are already recognized as people practicing, the function. They have the thinking.
What have you got to say about the digital marketing education and the how can one stay up to date?
Now you can show the actual value a campaign adds to the organization in terms of, if they want to say in terms of engagement, they can tell, okay, this many millions were reached. This was the engagement. And if they want to see how many orders were confirmed, you can easily show that in numbers, with the actual numbers for the finance to say. And if they want to see how much revenue that particular campaign brought, you can show that. And how many leads it generated, you can actually sort of show that. Earlier, what happened? You have to rely on how many newspapers were circulated. We put a full page ad on this newspaper which has 500,000 circulation a day or whatever, right? What does that mean? It doesn't mean anything, right? And now marketers can be more strategic because they're talking about data, they're talking about how they use different kinds of data to sort of arrive in decisions, and how this particular customer was identified, profile was created, and all of that, right? So basically, digital marketing enables putting the actual marketing principles into practice in a much better way.
What is the exact qualification they need to pursue, whether it is an academic qualification or a professional qualification? What is your view about it? Let's start with Aruz.
What is relevant for you? In terms of what is important for you? Now, why am I asking this question? What is important for you? If all those who are aspiring to be marketers, do they want to do the same thing? Or you want to do one specific element? Or where do you want to go? There is a quote saying that always begin with the end in mind. Your outcome is to be that when you qualify, when you graduate, the corporate sector should be able to see value in you and they should be able to employ you. Before you want to specialize, understand the general platform. And then you could decide what is best for you. Because we all come with a very unique set of capabilities and strengths. And our passion and our interest could be something very different to each other. So not all marketers would end up doing the same thing. So in that context, I think if you want to debate, you can compare the two in the context of in line with where you want to go, then you evaluate your pros and cons. But in a corporate setting, because we all come from corporate, I think a professional qualification definitely has its edge over the academic qualification. I am not saying academic qualification is bad in any sense. I'm saying that you cannot limit yourself as corporate professionals. You cannot limit yourself with an academic qualification. If so, that gap that I was talking about would get created. So therefore, either you want to look at options where you can combine the best out of everything, where you take the academic components. Without a fundamental understanding of marketing, you can't build academic competencies. You can't build professional competencies. But therefore, it's important. We are not in the point of, at least I am not in the point of view that academic is bad. But what I'm saying is, on top of academic, you need to equip yourself with the professional aspects of marketing. The importance of being a practitioner in marketing. Most of the professional qualifications today is not just 100% professional led. There is the fundamentals of thought, the subject matters, the theories are explained. Also, when it comes to Slim PGDIP, there is a very active research component inbuilt in it. Now you might think, well, his research is all about academic. Not necessary. In every corporate problem or issue or a crisis you face with, you need to carry out a research to kind of find out what the solution is.
So when selecting, I agree with Aruz, when selecting a qualification, you have to look at, and deciding between academic and professional, you have to look at these factors and then figure out what is the qualification that's right for you that meets these parameters. So basically, yeah, that's how I would look at it.
Academic qualifications are good to put the foundation, you know, and, you know, to understand the basic, the principles. But the professional qualification is what sharpen your mind and, you know, improve your thinking and optimize the way that, you know, you can apply the actual concepts into practice, because there are, most of the time, the academic qualifications are delivered by full-time lecturers, you know, who is great in what they do. But the professional qualifications, the people who deliver that program, most of the time, are people who are actually in the business world.